Well, we have yet another development in the saga of Windows 11 compatibility on older computers. So you may have heard last month when I made the video talking about how Microsoft supposedly would not block anyone from installing and upgrading to Windows 11 even if you had an older CPU that wasn't supported, although there would still be some hard requirements like TPM 1.2 and Secure Boot probably, but that they were not going to advertise this in any way and officially would not be supported. But then shortly after that video at the time, Microsoft then immediately came to say, oh, well, actually, yeah, you technically won't be blocked from it, but you're not going to be able to get any Windows updates if you do that, which kind of defeats the purpose of updating. I mean, if you can't even get like security updates, that is not something you would want to do. And at the time, I decided, you know what, I'm not going to make yet another update video. I'm going to wait a little bit to see what happens because Microsoft is releasing so many mixed signals. It's like they're flip-flopping back and forth. Yeah, you can. No, you can't. Blah, blah, blah. I was like, all right, let's wait. But recently, as of a few days ago, we do have some more significant details. And I specifically wanted to make it today because, yes, Windows 11 is being released next week. However, the actual release version that will be released is now available to Windows insiders. Like the final version, you can download the ISO, run it yourself. So we kind of already have the final version. And really the main significant development that I want to talk about is a new waiver, basically, that will come up if you try to do an upgrade from Windows 10 to Windows 11 on non-supported hardware. I'll go over what it says in a second, but it's kind of interesting how you get to this because if you just run the installer from the ISO on a Windows 10 computer normally, it will just completely block the upgrade. It'll say, yeah, it's not supported, you can't continue at all. However, what I found is that the way to get this to appear, apparently, is to actually enroll that Windows 10 computer into the Windows Insider program. Specifically, I did the dev channel, and then it came up after running the installer. Now, how this will play out on the final actual release day, I'm not sure. If you try to do an in-place upgrade on Windows 10 while you're not in the Insider program, will it show you the block message or the warning message? And I have seen some people say that it blocks you unless you do a clean install from like bootable drives or something, then it'll let you install even if you're not like in the Insider program. So we'll have to see. On release day, it might not even let you do an in-place upgrade. You might have to do a clean install. So anyway, going back to that warning message, you can see this one's kind of unique because it has an accept button, almost like it is like a terms of service. Like, yeah, I accept the warnings, whatever. And it says, this PC doesn't meet the minimum system requirements running Windows 11, blah, 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 blah. But the most significant part is, if you proceed with installing Windows 11, your PC will no longer be supported and won't be entitled to receive updates. Damage to your PC due to lack of compatibility aren't covered under the manufacturer warranty. By selecting accept, you're acknowledging that you read and understand the statement. But this is still kind of vague because it says your PC won't be entitled to receiving Windows 11 updates, but it doesn't explicitly say that you won't get them. I really wish Microsoft would kind of stop with these mixed messages and just be straight with everyone because this could mean like one of two things. It could mean that, yeah, your computer's not going to be able to update at all, getting Windows updates, even security updates, whatever. It's like you install, yeah, you can install Windows 11, but then you're not going to be able to do anything past that. In that case, it would be extremely bad to install Windows 11, in my opinion. The other possibility is that your computer still technically will get updates. However, they are not guaranteed to work or could potentially break something because they're not anticipating it to be run on older hardware. Now, I'm kind of hoping and expecting that it might be the second one. I think if they were going to completely block it, they probably would have used stronger wording on it, but I don't know. All that being said though, based on what I've been reading, I would probably personally strongly recommend against installing Windows 11 on any unsupported hardware. And I won't be installing it on my main computer, which runs Windows 10 and doesn't support Windows 11. And here's why. At first, Microsoft was really cagey and not clear about why the required CPUs were what they were. They kind of had this seemingly arbitrary cutoff and didn't say why. They're just like, yeah, your CPU is too old, but we're not going to tell you why. But later on, they made some statements that basically revealed that what it probably came down to is this type of technology for security called virtualization-based security, VBS, and also a sub-feature of that which is called memory integrity. And as Microsoft puts it, this is a feature that prevents attacks from inserting malicious code into high security processes. But here's the point with all this. Newer CPUs and suspiciously lining up exactly with the hardware requirements of Windows 11, all the ones that are supported support a feature called MBEC, or memory-based execution control. And you can basically think of this as a hardware feature built into newer CPUs that lets the computer do this memory integrity very quickly, so it's not going to affect the performance of the computer. Whereas on older CPUs that don't have this hardware accelerator built in, they have to do it kind of manually, you can think of it as, which has a huge potential hit on performance. So any CPU that is going to try and do memory integrity but doesn't have this MBEC feature is going to potentially have a performance hit of up to 40%. So you can understand why you probably don't want to be using this security feature on an older computer. And with it being such an important part of Windows 11 and its security, it makes sense why they wouldn't support older CPUs that don't have this feature. Because if they did, then people upgrading from older computers, not only would their computers like start off being slower because they're older, then they would potentially get an additional hit of 40%. People would be furious upgrading to Windows 11. Although the one thing that kind of throws a wrench in this theory is that even though Microsoft requires all computers to be able to support VBS, virtualization-based security, they're not gonna require it to be on by default. So why require it? I have to assume that if Microsoft is doing all these super strict hardware requirements, that there must be a reason for it, which I'm guessing might be features or updates in the future that will actually require this ability. And what this could mean is that because they have this assumption that all Windows 11 computers are gonna overwhelmingly have these requirements, or at least they should, then they can start creating more drivers and better features and stuff that don't necessarily have the restrictions of needing to be compatible with older stuff, which could potentially explain the wording they used in that warning. So yeah, you might still be able to technically install the updates. They won't explicitly say that you won't get them, but there is a chance that they might decide to release features and drivers and stuff in the future that do like physically require these kind of features. And anyone who is running hardware that isn't supported, well, they're gonna go and install a automatic update that's gonna be installed from Windows, and then it's gonna potentially break some stuff. Or maybe they are running a really old piece of hardware that has a old driver that works on their older hardware, but maybe Windows, for example, releases a newer driver that works fine on a newer computer, but if you try to use the newer driver on the older computer, it's gonna not let that device work, if that makes sense. So it could break a lot of stuff potentially, and this is all theoretical, but it would kind of explain things. Yeah, you could install the drivers, but you're gonna start getting updates eventually that are not gonna be very good. And of course, you have to understand that, yeah, it's your fault. They kind of warned you that this could happen. This is not a problem for people who do meet the requirements. But again, all that is assuming that technically you still will be able to get the updates until you come across one that's physically incompatible with your computer. If Microsoft were to completely block updates, I think that would be not a very good move. I don't see the justification in that, but we'll have to see. I kind of would be surprised if that was the case. But either way, based on what I was talking about, hopefully now you should kind of understand why I definitely would not recommend installing Windows 11 if your hardware is not supported, because it might not be a problem right now, but it could in the future. And that's not a risk I'm gonna take on my computer, and I probably don't think you should on yours. Anyway, hopefully this cleared some things up and hopefully didn't confuse even more things. But if you did enjoy the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you wanna subscribe, be sure to also enable the bell, because I release videos twice a week. You don't want it to get lost in your subscription feed. If you guys wanna keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is my previous video where I was talking about that update where Microsoft was talking about how they won't block updates, but now you can watch it again with the context of this video. So thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.